Now, Storm Tracker weather with East Idaho's chief meteorologist, Doug Iverson.
Tracking a little rain, a little thunderstorm up in Fremont County. I've been showing you the webcams. We've been following the storm as it moves off towards the northeast. A little bit of a bullseye. In fact, a couple little eyeballs, if you will. One right around Ashton, another one just south of there. It will continue its push across West Yellowstone, clipping Yellowstone National Park, and eventually move up into Montana. We are watching some activity upstream, but most of this should stay well to the west of the Snake River Plain. All we really have to look at for the rest of the night, at least for Pocatello, Colorado Falls, just a bunch of clouds will continue to stream in from northern Utah, and those clouds will keep us a little bit on the warm side. What's new? It's been pretty mild at night. Lows in the 50s. We're going to see that again tonight. Well, right now we're in the 70s, 76 at Pocatello, almost 80 at Salt Lake City. It sure has cooled off over in Boise. Usually they're warmer than we are. 69 degrees, stormy weather there. 70 right now up in Lewiston. Pendleton at 64. Burns only at 57. Yeah, we got some of those 50s for highs headed our way. It's not going to stay this nice temperature-wise for long. So for the rest of the evening, Snake River Plain, isolated rain showers and thunderstorms. Most of the activity has already moved on, so basically a mostly cloudy sky overnight. Look at the lows. Pretty mild. Generally speaking, we should see them at least in the 30s. We are above freezing this point this time of year, but these are on the warm side, way above freezing. Scattered showers and thunderstorms for the central mountains, so hit and miss. Low temperatures will generally stay in the 40s. Hit and miss showers and thunderstorms for the upper highlands in western Wyoming. All of us above freezing, including Yellowstone. And it looks like for the southeast corner, just clouds. Lows in Malad City. And in Downey and in Lava, in the lower to mid-50s. Mild across the map. Then tomorrow, umbrella weather required. Umbrella required for the weather, at least. We got rain likely later in the day. Risk of thunderstorms. High temperatures still in the 60s and still in the 70s. Could be cooler, I guess. It will certainly be that here in a couple of days. Don't you worry. We got rain likely for the upper highlands in western Wyoming. There's a risk of thunderstorms as well. High temperatures in the 60s and in the 70s. Of course, one exception being Yellowstone. For the central mountains, there's a chance later in the day of some showers and thunderstorms. Highs lower 60s to the mid-70s. Salmon, you'll be one of the warmer spots at 76. Pocatello tomorrow, we'll have a high of 75. We'll start off dry. And then as the day wears on, the chances of showers and thunderstorms will increase. Likely, we'll get the rain tomorrow night and certainly some thunderstorms as we go into your Friday. And, well, I guess we'll take a look at it, right? Southeast Idaho Chevy dealer 7 days forecast. What a drop. 75 tomorrow to only 50. That's if we're lucky. And we got wind along with the rain, so definitely a bad hair day. And there's a chance of rain Saturday clear through next Wednesday. 60, that's the warmest we can muster up after tomorrow. Idaho Falls 7-day forecast, just a wet and cool, windy end to the work week. 48, rain and wind. We'll try to warm up on Sunday. We'll go right back down with high temperatures in the 50s for the Teton area. Cool enough this weekend. We have rain and snow for Saturday and Sunday with a chance of rain, just rain Monday through Wednesday with highs still struggling to reach into the 50s. And for the central mountains, we're a chance tomorrow, but definitely wet weather for your Friday. Could see wet weather all weekend long.